Hi, today look at this random aircraft control panel, quite obscure, called C-TOT, with just two things here on the front, a safety switch with three positions, not sure what is going on with the holes here, and one very nice clicky potentiometer. So first thing, you will notice something unusual. Look carefully. I did never see it before. The Zeus fasteners here have an hexagonal head, Allen head. Usually it is slotted. First time ever I see it. So apparently this panel should be from Saab 340 aircraft, according to what I found. So it will be actually a pretty quick teardown because, as you will see, it is already opened. Top side, very nice green anodized aluminium here. Very Boeing kind. Also, you will notice the torque set screws. So, oddly enough, there is no really manufacturer name written on it. There is just those stickers with part number you will find on the web, on serial number. No real date code either. Test points here. You can see here already the mechanism for the potentiometer with a ball bearing that is spring loaded and adjustable. Interesting. So apparently we have here a parts list for the right engine. And for left engine, yes, it is a two-engine aircraft, the Saab 340. And on the top, look at this, it is coming, it came like this, it is designed to be like this, already opened, so it will be a pretty easy teardown. So, you can notice the very, very nice construction, military kind of quality. So another look here for you at the potentiometer system. Quite interesting. The potentiometer, it is a stack of two potentiometers. The connection here to the backlight of the front panel. The switch seems to be a US made model. Date code of 1989 apparently. And it is interesting to note the wires are screwed in. Apart from that, we have two resistors here, relays here, that are mounted onto those sockets with, I am not sure why you have the 3D parts here which are not used, quite interesting. You can see the over-engineered construction here for the brackets with secured captive nuts. More relays here, four of them. Here on each side we have five trim pots by VRN apparently brand, which are secured with orange goop. Same here, so apparently it is really a two symmetrical construction from here. Two channels in this construction. And maybe the most unusual part here will be this connector. Usually you have round connectors on two aircraft panels, but not here we have this kind of plugs I did never see before, made by Reichem. So very nice quality. You can see all the wires have their designation number stamp on them, or laser engraved or something. Really, really nice construction. Look, here they did even put heat shrink over the unused contacts of the relays. So really, really impressive. I got this item for 30 euros on a classified websites, so it was really a good deal, I believe. Obviously, all the hardware is Imperial, so it should be sad to do a video without taking anything apart. And anyways, I want to clean behind this panel, so I will remove it. Maybe we will find additional information about manufacturer or something. Suspense. First, I need to remove this button. Just two tiny Imperial set screws. If I manage to grab this one. Not always easy, these things. I do not want to damage the front panel, obviously. Maybe, okay. So just a clear plastic button here, as you can see. Then, it is not expected, but we have orange background in here. And two screws to undo. Not too hard, this one. Okay, could be worse. I do not want to damage the heads because they are difficult to find Imperial screws and they are painted in the matching color. So if I pop it out, what will happen? Okay. So as you can see, more Torx set screws, the connector to the backlight, some dust to clean as expected. But here, okay, Lucas Aerospace, Airport Luton. So apparently, British made part, which I was not expecting. And written information here with a serial number, which is actually quite huge compared to the serial number of the device. Interesting, that code of 92. So, either the parts did have really some stock. Yes, that code of 90 here. So yes, it is matching. 92, but I was not expecting to find at least we have a brand for this part at least. And you can see it is completely contained on sealed unit. We have obviously lights inside here, but with this nice golden connector. But you cannot replace the bulbs here, it is completely sealed. Interesting. Okay. So, quite unusual panel. One cable retainer is missing here, I will remake one. Okay, super, super nice construction. Nice color of the aluminium, by the way. And you can notice each part has its reference number stamped, glued. So probably super labor intensive construction here. Obviously, mostly all made by hand. Okay. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.